Savior Jesus Christ has allowed me to be in this place at this time for this occasion. Now, I really agree on behalf of my pastor, Pastor Fred Little, and the Franklin Avenue Baptist Church family. And I had to get a special pass to be here on Sunday because I'm in the mail course, and we start seeing at about 7:30, so I got a special pass to be here on today. Just want to come in fellowship and just kind of be with the Baptist Church family. Pastor mentioned much about it. I really don't like to come to churches, I guess, a lot, because I sat in church a long time, long before I was elected to office, and I oftentimes it seemed as if politicians don't show up at your churches when it's time to run for office.
Amen.
Amen. I'm tired of it, and I laughed at it because I was laughing at his brother right there. When I was 5 years old, Sister Seola came forward and taught me that song, just like Brother Walter taught that sister that song. I didn't sound nearly as good as she sounded at Pleasant Valley Christian Baptist Church, but we definitely sung that song. I had the good fortune of working with 48,000 individuals who called the Lord Night Walk New Orleans East Home, meaning the same individual that our honorable councilman, Councilman James Rick, has represented. And with a door that's been opened, I have the opportunity to now talk myself to the citizens of District 4, the 89,976 individuals who live in this area and areas all across the area. I'm here to ask for your support, I'm here to ask for your vote, but probably more so than that, just simply here to ask for your prayers. I have asked somebody much bigger than the city of New Orleans, much bigger than state of Louisiana, and we're trying to do what God has purposed me to do in this time, in this season. I would ask for your support, and one, keep me in your mind, and we'll be coming to your neighborhoods, we'll be talking to Pastor. Pastor, thank you very much. This church has always been an active force. When I was student in college, when Pastor W. Bridges was here, we had a chance to know the phenomenal work that he did, and I just want to thank you for the opportunity to come and fellowship with the AGB after church.
Two other quick announcements, three of them. First of all, I want to thank everyone for the love and the show of love on last week. Certainly, very much appreciated. Following that, on Wednesday night, we had a serious kind of episode to take place here at the church. We had a young man come in with a hoodie, shorts, backpack. I don't want to say fit the profile, because I don't like really profiling. We need to pay attention. We need to be very vigilant about what's going on in and around our churches. I thank God for Brother Johnson and other brothers who are here to handle that situation, but even they put them in a very precarious situation, because had that, and we talked about this Tuesday night at our Bible study, had that man put his hand on anything, we would have had to react to that. And so we ask that you continue to be cautious. We're asking for more brethren to be visible on Wednesday and Tuesday nights. We need your presence in and around the church. Again, we will have cameras installed soon. We're working on that. But again, we're asking everyone. It was a very, I can imagine, a very tense situation in April on Wednesday night. And so again, let's be cautious. I'm not saying this for you to stay home. Amen. For God has not given us the spirit of fear, of power, love, and sound mind. And so we do ask that you continue to come out and pray, but also at the same time be cautious about what's going on. And I say fit profile because on yesterday, as I was riding down Canal Street, it's 108 degrees outside, there's a young man with a wool cap. I said, well, you know something wrong with him. And so those are the kind of things you need to be looking for as you're going in and about. Your walks. Also, we had an announcement for the 10-year appreciation banquet, which we had a committee to get together to start looking at possibly where we could have this banquet. The committee came back with a list of hotels, and we decided on the high rates. Initially, the ticket started out at like $70, and I said, no, we can't do that. I want everybody, all of our church members, to be able to afford it. And so what we've done is we can start paying on it today. Amen. You can pay $5. And even up until next year, we got until what, July 16th. And so we can pay it every week. But we don't want to make it affordable, amen, for everybody.
Just save the date.
To come. And so that's why that's there at this time. So pray with us and pray for us again. We ask that you support Brother Bishop. He's doing a great job now. You do know that he will do a great job in our future. God bless you. God keep you. This is the moment of tithing. Tithing is God's program. Tithing is what the Lord would have all of us to do. He says this word to bring you all the tithe into the storehouse, that they may be meet in my house and prove me now, he will sit along for those defiled, and I will put you in the middle of heaven and pour you out of next